guys, welcome back to Math in a Hoodie. I hope you guys are ready to become some math warriors today. I've got my favorite hoodie on. Today we're going to break down the concept of adding and subtracting unlike mixed numbers, okay? So in a previous video, we talked about what unlike mixed numbers are. A mixed number, just to review, is a whole number with a fraction, two types of digits mixed together. And we're just adding or subtracting them. Okay, so let's get right into it. Here is our first problem. We have 2 4/12 plus 3 4/6. Now we know from previous videos that we cannot add or subtract a fraction unless they have like denominators, which means the same, right? So like just means the same. So unlike would mean not the same, wouldn't it? So 12 and 6 are not the same. So we always go ahead and set these types of problems up. We stack them on top of each other because we need to create new fractions that have the same denominators so that we can go ahead and compute or add and subtract. So it's easier to see our work and not to miss a step if we stack mixed numbers on top of each other. Okay, so let's go ahead and put equal and a line for our new fractions and go ahead and find our common denominator. So we have a 12 here and a 6 here. Now some of you may be able to look at that and see right away what the new denominator will be, but for the rest of us, let's go ahead and find the multiples of these two numbers and see where we can go from here. So let's go ahead and just do it right underneath, since I haven't really saved any room for us, but let's go ahead and start with a 12. Okay, so multiples of 12, we have 12 times 1 is 12. 12 times 2 is 24. Good job. Let's just do 3 for 12. And 12 times 3 is 36. Okay, so there's three multiples for 12. Now let's come down to 6. Okay, let's see if we can match any of these. You may already see what it is, huh? So 6 times 1 is 6. 6 times 2 is 12. Ding, ding, ding. Let's do one more. 6 times 3 is 18. Okay, do we have a common multiple? We do. We have 12. That is our least common multiple. So we are going to make that our new denominator, aren't we? Let's go ahead and put the 12 over. And now we need to figure out what our new numerators are. So what we do to the bottom, we have to do to the top. Remember, that's the rule for fractions. When you're computing, what you do to the bottom or the denominator, you have to do to the top or the numerator. So how did we get from 12 to 12? What did we multiply that by? We multiplied it by 1, so we have to do it to the top. So we did that. 4 times 1 is 4. Okay, let's do the same thing down here. What did we multiply 6 by in order to get to 12? 2. Dose. 6 times 2 is 12. Let's go ahead and do it to the top number or the numerator. 4 times 2 is 8. Now, are these like fractions? They are. So we can go ahead and add. Ooh, this is going to be interesting, isn't it? Okay, so let's go ahead and add our whole numbers. 2 plus 3 is 5. This is going to be basic math again. Now let's focus on these two fractions here. 4/12 and 8/12. What does that equal, guys? What is 4 plus 8? We're always going to keep the same denominator, aren't we? So we just need to add the numerators. 4 and 8 is 12. Now, is that our answer? 5 with 12 over 12? You could put that as your answer, but it wouldn't be right, would it? Because is 12 and 12 actually a fraction? If we had a piece of pie and we divided it, let's see, that's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's really terrible dividing. But if we divided into 12 pieces and all of them were colored in, would that really be a fraction, or would that be the whole pie? That would be the whole pie, isn't it? That would be one whole pie. Any number over itself is the whole piece, and it equals one. So we can't have 5 12 12 twelfths. That actually turns into one, so we're going to add those together. So it's actually, here's our arrow for the final answer. Our final answer is 6. Geez, the first one we did was kind of tricky, guys. Okay, we see how we did that first. We had to move our fractions into like fractions so that we could add them, and we add our whole number, which gave us the 5. We added our fractions, which gave us the 12 over 12, which isn't a fraction, it's actually a whole number. So we're gonna add those together, and our answer was 6. Let's do a simpler one, shall we? Okay, let's do our second problem, which is gonna be much easier. This is gonna be a subtraction this time, okay? And we're subtracting 6 4/9 from 5 1/3, okay? We're not gonna do anything to the whole numbers because those we can subtract down. But our fractions, are they like fractions? Do they have the same denominators? They don't. So we need to find out what the new denominator will be, get some new fractions that are like fractions, so we can simply subtract down, okay? So let's go ahead and do our multiples of the numbers of our denominators to figure out what the new one's going to be. Let's start with the 3. What's 1 times 3? 3. What's 2 times 3? 6. What's 3 times 3? 9. Let's just do 3. I think we'll be all right. You might be able to see right away which one it's going to be, huh? All right, let's do the 9. Multiples of 9. What's 1 times 9? It's 9. What's 2 times 9? 18. And what's 3 times 9? 27. The light bulb go off for you yet? Do you see the common multiple? Yes, 9. Okay, so let's go ahead and put the common multiple as our new denominator, which is 9. Now we need to figure out what our numerators are going to be, and we remember the rule, what we do to the bottom, we have to do to the top. So let's start with the 3 and 9. How did we get from 3 to 9? What did we multiply it by? 3 times 3 is 9. Good. Now we need to multiply up here. 1 times 3 is 3. Okay. All right, let's do our top fraction. What times 9 gave us 9? It's a really hard one, guys. That is a 1. We do it to the top number. 4 times 1 is 4. Now we can go ahead and look at our new fractions, can't we? So now we can solve. We're ready to go. So 6 minus 5 is what, guys? Super hard first grade subtraction. 6 minus 5 is 1. Okay. Now we have 4/9 minus 3/9. Again, the denominator, the downstairs number changes. All we need to do is figure out the numerator. What's 4 minus 3? Again, super tricky. It's 1. So our answer is 1 1/9. See, I told you that would be an easier one, isn't it? Okay, let's go ahead and do one more. All right, guys, here is our last mixed numbers that we are going to add, okay? All right, let's figure this out. So we're gonna leave our whole numbers alone. Those are just fine. Our fractions of 2/5 and 1/6 are not like, so we can't just simply add down and say 3/11. Can't do that, can we? So let's go ahead and set it up so we don't get lost along the way. Okay, let's start with our multiples of the denominators to find out what our new denominator is going to be. Okay, so 5 times 1 is 5. 5 times 2 is 10. 5 times 3 is 15. I think we're gonna need more with this one, guys. We gotta go a little higher. Well, what's 5 times 4? It's 20. Very good. 5 times 5 is 25, and one more. 5 times 6 is 30. Woo! We had to do a lot this time, didn't we? All right, let's do the multiples of 6. 6 times 1 is 6. 6 times 2, 12, a dozen, good job. 6 times 3 is 18. 6 times 4, 24. Do we have anything in common yet? 9, 9. Let's keep going. 6 times 5 is 30. There she is. There she blows. It's 30. That is the least common multiple. Okay? So that's going to be our new... This is going to be a big one, isn't it? All right. So I'm going to erase this just so we have room to put our new numerator, guys. Just so we don't get confused. Okay, there we go. So I'm going to make that one a little bigger. Okay, so what we do to the bottoms, we've got to do to the top, right? How did we get from 5 to 30, guys? What did we multiply by? We multiplied by 6. What we do to the bottom, we have to do to the top. 2 times 6 is 12. Okay, let's do the bottom fraction. 1 sixth. What did we multiply the 6 by to get to the 30? 5. Very good. And we do that to the top. What's 1 times 5? 5. Okay, now that we're all set, right? We've got our new fractions that are like. We can simply add straight down. Let's start with the whole numbers. 2 and 8 is 10. Our answer in the whole number is going to be 10. Okay, let's do the fraction now. We're adding again. 12 plus 5. I was just going to write the denominator because that never stays. I mean, that never changes, does it? It always stays the same. So we're just going to put 30 over. Now let's add the numerator. Sorry. So 12 and 5 is super hard first grade math, makes it 17. There's your number. Now you do need to check to see if you can simplify. We didn't do that last time because we couldn't simplify, but I should have brought that up so we at least check. 17 and over 30, we can't simplify either of those. 17 is a prime number. So that would be the end. And your answer is 10. 17 thirtieths. Pretty big, isn't it? Okay, guys, I hope this has helped you review mixed numbers, adding some subtracting, or if it was your first time, I hope it kind of helped you lay a foundation for you to build on as you keep doing exercises. Okay, you guys did so great. Have a great day, and I'll see you guys next time on Math in a Hoodie.